Are you sick and tired of your slow-moving CNC router caused by lame stepper motors? You want to upgrade to servos, but you are afraid of the dreadful tuning process? Well, in this video, I will show you a quick and dirty, hands-down approach to achieve a good servo tuning without long and boring lectures about PID controllers that nobody cares to understand anyway. Hello, and welcome to my channel. All the CNC routers that I have built so far had servos, because they have significant benefits over simple stepper motors and as well over closed-loop steppers. In my latest build, I use iHSV servos from JMC with 400 watt on Y and Z and two 440 watt servos in a tandem configuration on X. They have an integrated driver attached to the motor body, which saves a lot of space in the controller cabinet, and they have a reasonably good price. When it comes to the tuning, however, they are a bit more challenging, because they do not have an auto-tuning feature that more expensive servos have, like the ones from Delta or others. Their tuning software can measure the load-to-inertia ratio of an axis and adjust the servo parameters accordingly, which usually gives already an acceptable tuning for most hobby machines. The iHSV servos do not have such a feature. What they call auto-tuning is in fact just a collection of different parameter sets depending on the chosen stiffness value. These parameter sets are identical regardless if it is a 100 watt or a 660 watt servo, so no real auto-tuning. But when you know what to look for, it is still fairly easy to tune them, and I will show you now how it is done. The first thing that you need is a good USB to RS232 serial adapter. I put a link in the description below to the one I use. I have tried a few others and they all had connection issues, but this one definitely works. After connecting the servo to the computer, you need to open the tuning software, enable the servo, and start. In addition, you need to have your CNC control software open with a small program that moves the axis back and forth. When the tuning software successfully connects to the servo, the communication status on the bottom switches from red to green. Then you can access the parameters. There you have several different tabs. The parameters fixed to the servo type, the main control parameters, the gain parameters, position, speed, and torque parameters, I/O, and advanced function parameters. CNC routers work in position mode, so the tabs for speed and torque parameters can be ignored. And as well, I/O and advanced functions we can skip for the moment. At the beginning, we have to change the parameter PO102 from 0, which is a completely manual tuning function, to 1. In order to access the preset gain parameters depending on the stiffness value set later in PO103. Do not use the setting 2 in this case, because this will fix the value PO203 to 30%, and I will show you later why this is not ideal. When you change a parameter, you need to download the value to the servo. Once the auto adjust is selected, you can start to change the stiffness value at PO103. When you switch to the gain parameter tab, however, you will not see any changes because you have to upload the changed parameters from the servo first. This is a bit complicated, but you get used to it pretty quickly. I'm changing the stiffness back to the default value of 13 because I would like to show you that the servo is pretty much useless for a CNC machine with this setting. I could turn the pulley a couple of degrees without any problem, and the compensation from the servo is rather sluggish. So in the next step, we open the oscilloscope of the tuning software. Here you can track and compare all sorts of parameters, but the one we will focus on is the so-called position follow error. This shows how many steps the servo is actually lagging behind the position command, and this is the key criteria for the tuning. After this, I start the movement of the axis. I usually tune the servo at a feed rate of 5 m/min, which is a typical milling feed. As you can see, the servo lags at the start about 1,000 steps behind the actual position command, and then fluctuates in very small steps while the axis moves in one direction. And when the servo reverses the direction, it again lags about 1,000 steps behind, just in the other direction. At this point, it might be useful to explain a little bit the resolution settings. The servos have a dip switch where you can select the number of steps per revolution. The maximum pulse frequency these servos can handle is 200 kHz. I have a target feed for rapid movements of 50 meter per minute and a 5 mm pitch ball screw. This results in a servo speed of 3000 revolutions per minute or 50 revolutions per second. With the max frequency of 200 kHz, this gives a max resolution of 4000 steps per revolution. On the 5 mm pitch ball screw, this is then a resolution of 1.25 microns per step. I have started this calculation from the max frequency of the servo because my CNC controller can output up to 400 kHz. But some controllers, like the Maso G3 or the cheaper editing boards, have a pulse frequency put around 110 to 125 kHz. And in this case, you would have to do the calculation of the servo resolution starting with this value. I will show you now the impact on the position follow error when you gradually increase the stiffness value and the software adjusts the subsequent preset gain values. You can do this on the fly while the servo is still running. A change from 13 to 14 already results in the drop from 1000 steps to 750 steps, which is still around 1 mm deviation and totally unacceptable for a CNC router. The change from 14 to 16 brings a further improvement to 500 steps deviation. As you can see, with the change from 16 to 18, the improvement of the position follow error starts to become smaller. When you get into the lower 20 values, another focus point becomes interesting, and this is the sound of the servo. Now, this axis runs on a timing belt, which makes it a little bit more difficult to listen to vibrations and disharmonics, but this is the point where the servo can begin to oscillate when it tries to compensate too quickly. And when I change from 22 to 24, you can already hear how the servo and the axis starts to squeak. But the result with 100 steps is still far from what we want. I even go from 24 to 26, which is already close to the max value of 31, just to show you that increasing the stiffness value will not lead to success. The axis starts to rumble a little bit, but we still have a deviation of almost 1/10 of a millimeter, and even 2/10 in the area of direction change. So I notched the stiffness value back to 21, which is an area where the axis still sounded good. In order to really improve the position following error, we have to change a different parameter, and that is PO203, the speed feed forward gain. And this, folks, is in reality the key parameter to get to the desired deviation. You remember that in the auto tune setting 2, this value is fixed to the default value of 30%. And that is why this setting is useless, and you have to set the parameter PO102 to 1. I will show you how an increase of this value will gradually improve the position error while the axis still sounds smooth. So at the value of 95, we are about 12 steps behind, which is 0.015 millimeters. This is already not too bad, but the deviation still changes with the direction. This is why we increase this value even further. At 99, we are already in the area of less than 10 microns position error, but even here we can still see a slight change in direction. And this is why this parameter ultimately has to be set at its max value of 100%. Now we can see that there is no influence of the direction change anymore, and the position error is fluctuating around the zero line by something between 1 and 2 steps, so less than 3 microns. Not too shabby for a woodworking router. You can also see that at a direction change, the servo overshoots sometimes a few steps, but this is in a level of 0.01 millimeter, and this is for me totally acceptable. You can also try and turn the pulley now, but the servo will immediately correct the position and the overall error is in the area of around 5 microns. This is, by the way, another good test to see if the axis is too stiff, because it should not sound like this. One final point that you should change is the tolerated position deviation before the servo goes into an error status. This is the parameter PO315. The value here is in fact multiplied by 10, and I have no clue why they have done it this way, but it is what it is. I set this value so the servo goes into an error when the position deviation is 0.1 millimeter, which on this axis is 80 steps. This value is particularly important for the tandem axis, to make sure that any distortion will stop the movement. And with this, your basic tuning is finished. I recommend that you save your new parameters on your hard drive and enjoy a CNC router with proper rapids. If you want to see the build of this router, I have linked the playlist in the description below. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell. Stay tuned and see you next time.